Hello everyone. So we are back with our next lecture series, that is CRISP sets. In the earlier session, what we did was regarding the introduction of fuzzy logic, what fuzzy means and what is fuzzy logic and why we are using this fuzzy logic. Now, in last lecture, I gave you a statement that this is an extension of conventional set theory. So here we are going to just understand the CRISP sets. What are CRISP sets? Basically, CRISP sets are nothing but these are the classical set theory we have studied till date. हमने जो classical set theory अभी तक पढ़ी है ये वही है जिसे हम CRISP set के नाम से अब बोलेंगे. A set is any well-defined object, collection of objects. आपका set क्या है? Basically, set is a collection of well-defined objects. Or object kya hai? It is a set of elements. Now, we have already studied. Aap sabhi ne set theory pehle se padhi hui hai. Aur usme hum bahut detail mein na jaate hue ek just a review karenge. That is, in a set capital A. Let's say this is capital A set and it has the elements from A1 to AN. That means how many elements we have in this set A, we have n number of elements, right? So if the elements AI, where I is what? I is equal to 1 to n, that means AI, A2, A1, A2, A3 till AN. So I is what? 1 to n of a set are subset of universal set X. There is a universal set named X and this set is the subset of universal set X. Then set A can be represented for all elements. That means small x belongs to this universal set by its characteristic function. So how we denote it, this one? This is the membership function of set A of universal set X, where if X belongs to universal set, that means this particular sign is for belongs to. If it belongs to, then you get the value as 1. Else you get the value as 0. That means if it belongs to, if it does not belongs to. Moving further, that means we only have two values, either 0 or 1. How? This characteristic function can be defined as a function in which a value of 1 for those elements where X belongs to set A, then we are getting the value 1. And if X does not belong to set A, then we are getting the value as 0, right? So the notation which will be expressed in mathematical form will be A colon X belongs to 0 or 1. That means AX ki value aapko 1 kab milegi? Jab X jo hai wo member hoga A ka. और AX की वैल्यू आपको जीरो कब मिलेगी जब X मेंबर नहीं होगा सेट A का. सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव. सो वी हैव ओनली टू वैल्यूज इन CRISP सेट, 0 एंड 1. CRISP का मतलब ही क्या था? व्हाट वी स्टडीड इन लास्ट लेक्चर वाज CRISP मींस दैट इट हैज क्लियर बाउंड्रीज. एंड व्हाट आर द टू बाउंड्रीज ऑफ CRISP? दैट इज 0 एंड 1. सो नथिंग इन बिटवीन. इट इज क्लियर कट, ईदर 0 और 1. So alternatively, the set A can be represented for all elements where X belongs to universal set X by its characteristic function mu A X, defined as, this we have already done, that is, it will be 1 if X belongs to universal set X and will be 0 in otherwise condition. And what is the otherwise condition? That is, if X does not belong to universal set X. So basic agenda of telling you all these things is that why we are calling this classical set theory as CRISP set. We are calling it as CRISP set because we have only the two values, that is 0 and 1. There is nothing in between. There is no other information in between. We only have two values which are the boundaries of this concept. So that is why this is called as what? CRISP sets. So now CRISP sets, in this we have certain concepts. What is this? This is termed to be as cardinality. This is described as cardinality. Family of sets, that is whose members are set themselves. जो मेंबर्स के सेट्स होते हैं वो फैमिली ऑफ सेट्स होती हैं. नल सेट दैट मींस व्हिच हैव नल वैल्यू. सिंगलटन सेट मींस इट हैज ओनली वन एलिमेंट इन द सेट. किसी भी सेट दैट मींस सेट ए में केवल एक एलिमेंट है. सबसेट एंड सुपरसेट. सुपरसेट वी ऑल नो व्हाट इज सुपरसेट. सुपरसेट इज द वन व्हिच इज हैविंग द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द सेट्स कैन बी ए बी एंड सी. Subset, the one which is having similar values is the subset. Now further, these are what? These were the simple concepts. Now in this we have certain operations which are performed on crisp sets, which can be union, intersection and difference, comparison, etc. Now in this union, what is this union? This particular is the one which is used as the sign of union. So A union B is what? It can be represented as the X is what? It belongs to A and X belongs to B. Here the main role plays is not and, as the or. That means if X set belongs to A or if it belongs to B, in any case the A union B will be the formation. Generalized union operation for a family set will be written in this way. Now the intersection of two sets, if I say intersection of A and B, this is the sign we are going to use, A intersection B, and we are going to define if the X belongs to both A and B. Agar A, X jo element hai, wo A aur B dono hi sets mein को बिलोंग करता है, only then it is going to give you the value for intersection AB. और यहाँ पे क्या कंडीशन थी? In either set, चाहे A में हो, चाहे B में, आपको वो union की value मिल जाएगी. So this was the operation. These are certain properties of crisp set. I'm again telling you that we are not going to have the numericals on these particular crisp set. This is just for the finding out that just a review of the crisp sets, what we are doing in conventional set theory. And depending on this, we are going to make the extension version of these particular sets, making it as fuzzy set. So somehow these are basically depending on the same way, the properties, these are the properties, involution property, you have studied commutativity, associativity, distributivity, absorption by X and Phi, identity, law of contradiction, law of excluded middle, T. Morgan's law. So now second thing is that is partition and covering. What is this partition? Partition on A is defined to be set of non-empty subset AI, which each of which is pairwise disjoint and whose union yields to the original set A. That means if what I'm going to do, I'm going to partition this capital A. This is a set A having these five elements. Now let's say I have A1 as AB, A2 as CD and AE as E. There is no, the intersection of these two sets is null. Intersection of these two sets is null. That means no element is common in all these three sets. So that, but when I make the union of these three sets, I get the set A. You can see here what I'm going to do. See, if I say that intersection, I'll get value null. If A intersection, A1 intersection A2, no common factor, that means null. A2 intersection A3, again null. A1 intersection A3, again null. But if I'm going to do the union, that is A union, A1 union, A2 union, A3. So that means what I'm going to do is, I'm going to get the final set as A. So this is called as partition. So A1, A2 and A3 are partition on A. Next one is covering. What is this covering? Covering is whenever there is a covering on a covering on A is defined to be a set of non-empty subsets AI whose union leads the original set A. the non-empty subsets need to be disjoint. That means जो non-empty subsets हैं उन्हें disjoint होना है and this particular union will give you again the value of A. A1 union A2 union A3 you'll get the value of set A only. Fine, which will be A, B, C, D and E. So this is what we are going to get. So that is called as A1, A2, A3 is covering on A. And that's all for today's session. This was just a, fast review of this CRISP sets. Thank you very much.